On this Griffon Newscast, the results are in. We'll have the outcomes of some of the most important ballot measures from last week's election and tell you how these new laws will affect you. That and much more is straight ahead. The Griffon Newscast starts now. Thanks for joining us. I'm Brittany Price. Last week, voters across the country went to the polls to speak their voice. One of the measures of Missourians voted on was an increase in the minimum wage. Proposition B passed with 62% of the vote. So what does this mean for Missouri workers? The minimum wage will increase 85 cents to $8.60 an hour on January 1st, 2019. Then increase an additional 85 cents per hour each year until 2023, when it will reach $12 per hour. This change will particularly affect student workers that make minimum wage.
Our allotments, say a federal work study, campus employment funds that we have, we wouldn't see a corresponding increase in that to help us cover it. So students would simply earn their award in fewer hours.
Another measure passed by Missouri voters was Amendment 2. Passing with 66% of the vote, this amendment legalizes the medical use of marijuana in Missouri. The amendment was one of three medical marijuana measures on the ballot, but was the only one to pass. Known as New Approach Missouri, the new law imposes a 4% tax on medical marijuana. Revenue from these taxes will go towards veterans programs. New Approach Missouri is also unique in that it will allow patients to grow their own marijuana. Patients who wish to take advantage of this will have to pay a $100 license fee and grow their marijuana in a state-registered facility.
I think the side effects with marijuana are a lot less than with the pharmaceutical companies. People OD on pills all day long, but I don't think you can OD on marijuana.
After a decade at Western, the dean and executive director of Western Institute is stepping down. Gordon Mapley recently announced his plans to retire at the end of this calendar year. Mapley also served as the dean and executive director of the Instructional Media Center, which is involved with nearly every technological aspect on campus. In his time at Western, Mapley was instrumental in growing the university's offering of online courses and has been passionate about helping students get their degrees. There is no word yet on Mapley's replacement. The International Center recently hosted an exciting celebration of all cultures on campus. The annual International Fair gave attendees the chance to meet some of Western's international students and get a taste, literally, of different cultures. The event included free food, music, and a fashion show, and cultural presentations. It was free and open to the public and provided a great educational opportunity to those who attended.
The intention is, you go to college and you either break out of your original hometown or you cultivate your hometown in some degree, and I think that would include understanding different cultures and allowing diversity to come into St. Joe, but also for people of St. Joe to understand diversity so that when they do enter the workplace in places like Kansas City or surrounding areas, they're not completely taken off guard and unaware of how to handle the situation.
The 48-hour film festival has called it a wrap for its eighth straight year. Seven teams participated in the competition, which was held from November 2nd through the 4th. Each team was challenged to create a film in 48 hours. They were given a specific character and their job, a certain prop, and a specific line of dialogue. All other aspects of the film were left to the teams. Some of the awards teams competed for included best writing, best editing, and best acting. We spoke with one of the nominees about the experience.
Staying up and trying to function as a person while doing acting and editing was just very difficult, but I had such a good time, and no matter who I worked with, I feel like 48 is definitely a really good opportunity for anybody who wants to be a filmmaker.
A screening and award ceremony was held in Potter Hall Theater on Thursday, November 8th. The best overall award went to a film entitled Rising Star. Pick up a copy of the Griffon News to find out more about all the stories making headlines at Missouri Western. You can also find us on Facebook or thegriffonnews.com. I'm Brittany Price, and that's your news in 5 minutes. Thanks for joining us.